Good morning and welcome to today's International Space Station update. The crew has been going through an array of different experiments and maintenance activities on board the station. Starting with Monday, Commander Burbank was working on something called the capillary flow experiment, which is a suite of fluid physics research projects that looks to see how fluids behave when they aren't under the influence of gravity and are only using capillary forces to move along. Anton Shkaplerov worked to relocate some items in the Russian segment from the Zarya stowage locations, and then his cosmonaut counterpart Anatoly Ivanishin was replacing some filters and the dust collectors again in that Zarya module. The third Russian cosmonaut on Monday, Oleg Kononenko, was working with the Russian relaxation experiment, which helps to determine the effects of different propulsion systems and their exhausts on the Earth's upper atmosphere. Andrei Kuipers was working with the VO2max experiment, which looks to evaluate the astronauts' maximal oxygen uptake and their respiratory performance both before, during, and after long-duration spaceflights. And finally, on Monday, Don Pettit was working with the SLICE experiment, which you'll also see him working on today. That SLICE stands for Structure and Liftoff in Combustion Experiment, which looks to investigate the nature of flames in microgravity. Moving down to Tuesday, Commander Burbank began some of the extensive work that's been going on this week with the water recovery system, removing a gas pocket that had built up inside of the contingency water container, which the astronauts were using in place to maintain the system while it awaited further repairs. Meanwhile, the Russian cosmonauts Anton Shkaplerov and Anatoly Ivanishin were involved in some audits of their photo and video equipment on board the station, and also beginning to take some footage for a Russian Life on the Station video, which will be seen by audience in Russia. Meanwhile, the third cosmonaut, Oleg Kononenko, worked with the Russian pneumocart experiment, which is an integrated study to look into how the astronauts' bodies adapt, specifically their cardiovascular systems, during these long durations spent in microgravity. Andrei Kuipers did some weekly cleaning activities, which he would continue for a few days. And then finally, Don Pettit was also doing some cleanup activities in the deck crew quarters, focusing on the intake and exhaust ducts, and also checking out their fan and airflow sensors. Moving on to Wednesday, we marked the first day of our robotic refueling operations. The first item on the list, first three days ever spent manipulating this payload, which arrived on the station back in last July. The operators down here on the ground went through a series of tool checkouts, and again, this is the first of 3 days, and they continued on Thursday and Friday as well. Commander Burbank continued his work on the water recovery system, replacing a multi-filtration unit with an on-orbit replacement unit. He was assisted throughout that day by Don Pettit. Meanwhile, Anton Shkaplerov was doing some routine light replacement throughout the Russian segment, and Anatoly Ivanishin got some time to work with the Matryoshka experiment, which is a mannequin-sized doll on board the station with an array of sensors throughout it that's used to gather data on radiation levels that the astronauts are experiencing during their stints on board the station. Meanwhile, Oleg Kononenko was replacing some integration panels inside of the POISC module, or the Mini Research Module 2, and also loading some hardware for eventual disposal onto the Progress 46 resupply craft. Then Andrei Kuipers is working to do some fire detection and suppression checkouts, verifying that some of the firefighting gear on board the station, including portable fire extinguishers, extension hoses, and different breathing apparatuses, were all free from damage to ensure their functionality. Moving on to Thursday, we had the second day of robotic refueling mission activities, where robotic ground controllers released 5 of the 7 multifunction tool adapter receptacle launch locks on board using the multifunction tool in conjunction with the space station's robotic arm, specifically using the Dexter, or the special purpose dexterous manipulator portion of that robotic arm. Meanwhile, Dan Burbank continued to remove and replace some items in the water recovery system, getting that failed catalytic reactor out and installing a temporary catalytic reactor filter before eventually installing the full replacement. And again, as he was on Wednesday, he was assisted with all of those activities by Don Pettit. The Russian cosmonauts were involved in a number of experiments. Anton Shkaplerov was working with the Uragan Earth Observation Project, which looks to monitor different areas where natural man-made disasters are forecasted to occur, using the space station's unique vantage point to provide controllers on the ground with data they wouldn't otherwise have. Anatoly Ivanishin, immediately upon wake up Thursday, was involved with the SPRUT-2 experiment, which looks to investigate the unfavorable impact of zero gravity on how well the astronauts stay hydrated. Oleg Kononenko was involved in some more Progress 46 stowage activities, unloading some cargo and moving some disposable items into the craft, as it will be burned up in the Earth's atmosphere upon its undocking and reentry later this year. And then Andrei Kuipers spent his time working with the Integrated Cardiovascular Experiment, which looks to study the heart muscle atrophy, or the weakening and lessening in size of the heart muscle, which occurs during spaceflight and these microgravity environment conditions that the astronauts are exposed to. And then finally this week, we move on to today, where we will have the last day of robotic refueling mission activities, where controllers both here on Mission Control Houston and at the Goddard Space Flight Center will continue to release some of the launch locks and then move on to using the wire cutting tool on two test wires if time permits. Commander Burbank will spend his entire day finishing up with that water recovery system removal and replacement repair work, installing that new catalytic reactor, and then taking the failed one and inspecting for the leak for some time before moving it for long-term stowage in order to preserve the option of a potential future repair and reinstallation of that failed device. Meanwhile, Anton Shkaplerov and Anatoly Ivanishin will spend a good portion of their day working on the Russian bar experiment, which looks to determine selection and testing methods in order to detect any depressurization that may happen inside of the International Space Station's modules. While they're doing this, Oleg Kononenko will be working with the Russian Rusalka test, and this looks to develop some procedures for determining the carbon dioxide and methane content in the Earth's atmosphere in order to better understand the role of natural processes and human activity on the content of these gases. Andrei Kuipers will be assisting Don Pettit with his own integrated cardiovascular scan. He did that a little bit earlier today. And then we'll also be assisting in doing some cleanup work, stowing all the tools that were necessary for that water recovery system work, and also cleaning up one of the corridors leading to the permanent multi-purpose module, or Leonardo. Then our final Expedition 30 crew member, Don Pettit, is returning to the work that he did on Monday with the SLICE experiment. Again, SLICE standing for Structure and Liftoff in Combustion Experiment, which looks to investigate the nature of flames in microgravity.